is very small. Wow, why is it not going online?
Okay, we are live. I hope that this is working. I have to speak a little bit slow because there's a lag of about 10 seconds. So, hello guys. I'm very happy and very excited about this crochet along. As you know, we made a voting for all of you to decide which was the pattern that we were gonna be crocheting, and you decided that we were gonna make the witch, which I crocheted first based in the sketches that I had, and now here it is. This is the witch that we will be crocheting today. Today we are gonna start with the head. For the head,
check first if many people are, at least if they can hear you.
Yeah, first we need to check if everything is running well for the tutorial. So if you are tuning in right now, please let us know if you hear us well, if you see us well, and if everything is fine so we can start. And yeah, so please let us know first. So we are gonna have like about 3 minutes of just testing and seeing if people starts coming, because it's 8 o'clock, zero, maybe not anymore, but so then people starts coming in. So let's see if you can hear us well, if everything is going well, and then we can continue so people don't miss a second of the thing. I hope that everything is well and that people are starting to tune in. I will get my phone pretty soon so then I can start answering your comments and your patterns. And we have a very awesome setup today that was made by John. So thank you to John for this. And yeah, so what time is it, John? Let's see, we have already 2 people connected. And now I have my phone here so I can answer your questions. I'm gonna just get it here. All right, so I think we are gonna start now with the people that is here.
Wait.
What?
It's not live.
Is it live or it's not live? Let's see. I think it is. Yeah, John, it is.
Ah, here it's just loading like that.
I wonder why. Maybe you can reload the page because I can hear myself. So yeah, I think it's working. I can see it here too. Okay, so we will wait. Okay, so we have one viewer and we are gonna start pretty soon. We are waiting maybe 30 seconds more. Now we have 3 viewers, so
it
would be really nice if you could tell us if you can hear us well, if you can see us well, so we can start in, because otherwise if you can't hear me well, then it's not gonna be that easy. Also, if the video quality is good enough, and then we start. So if anyone is there and can drop us a comment about that, it will be very good. Which time? Today we are making the head of the witch. It has a very furry hair, and then a hat, and then a dress and some underpants. And I think she hasn't slept so well because she has dark circles under her eyes. So, anyway, now we start. So, I hope that you can hear me well. I hope that everything is fine. So now we start with the Crocheta Long 2016, and we are starting today with the head. So the materials that you need for the head are, you need a crochet hook that is of 3.5 or 4 millimeters. Then you will need yarn, green yarn. I'm using worsted yarn, and a crochet hook of 4 millimeters. Then you will need a pair of safety eyes. I'm using safety eyes of 9 millimeters, but you can use also buttons, or you can use felt, or you can use whatever you have in your home. It doesn't have to be safety eyes. If you are planning to do this amigurumi for a child, I recommend that you do buy these buttons. Shortly in Spanish, for our followers in Spanish, los materiales que vamos a necesitar para el crochet along de la bruja, hoy que vamos a hacer la cabeza, son lana verde. Vamos a usar una aguja de 4 o de 3.5 milímetros y vamos a utilizar unos ojos de seguridad. Yo estoy usando ojos de 9 milímetros, pero ustedes pueden usar botones, o pueden usar perlitas, o pueden usar fieltro, o hacerlos con, ¿cómo se dice?, con costura. Y esos son los materiales principales. Los materiales secundarios son relleno. Yo estoy reciclando una, ¿cómo se dice esto?, una almohada. The other materials that you are gonna need are fiberfill stuffing. I'm recycling a pillow. So here you can see that there's some fluffy things. Then you will need a pair of scissors, unas tijeras, a stitch marker. If you don't have a stitch marker, you can use a piece of yarn of a different color. Un marcador de ¿cómo se dice? Un marcador para saber dónde va la costura. Si no tienes esto, puedes usar un pedazo de lana de otro color. And a tapestry needle, una aguja capotera. Those are the materials that we are gonna use today. Esos son los materiales que vamos a utilizar hoy. Bueno, lo que vamos a hacer hoy, the thing that we are gonna do today is the head of our amigurumi. As you can see, it's just a sphere. I have crocheted around until creating the sphere. And then I have added the details afterwards, and I added the eyes before closing in the bottom part. La esfera la he creado alrededor usando puntos bajos, y He instalado los ojos antes de terminar la parte de abajo y he hecho los detalles con la aguja capotera y eso se los voy a mostrar más tarde. The ears, I have made them afterwards, and that tutorial will be in the details of the amigurumi. Los detalles que ven aquí los hice después de terminar todo el proyecto y eso se los voy a mostrar en la fase final del amigurumi. La bruja, the witch, is green because she's very evil. So, I have chosen three contrasting colors that are the black, burgundy, green, and gray. So those are the colors that you are going to use in the whole tutorial. Los colores que escogí para esta bruja son verde, gris, negro y, ¿cómo se dirá? Rojo oscuro, vino tinto. Esos son los colores que vamos a utilizar durante todos los tutoriales y los escogí porque me parece que tienen buen contraste. Ok, so now we are gonna start. Ahora vamos a empezar. Now we are gonna start with round number one. In round number one, we are gonna stitch six stitches around into a magic ring. For that, we are gonna take our crochet hook and our yarn, and then we are gonna start. Shortly in Spanish. En el patrón vamos a empezar con la ronda número 1. Para la ronda vamos a hacer una, ¿cómo es que se dice? It's not working. It's not working.
Yeah, it works, but you can't put upload pictures into.
Okay, I can upload the pictures a little bit later then. John, can you show me please the pattern in Spanish? Can you tilt it a little bit so I can read? Yeah, en español les tengo que pedir disculpas porque es mi primer patrón en español. Vamos a hacer un anillo mágico de 6 puntos bajos. Bueno, entonces vamos a empezar. Magic Ring of Six. Uno, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Then after that, we are gonna close the magic ring and then we are gonna move to round number two. That is double single crochet in each stitch around. This is how it looks so far. In Spanish is en la segunda vuelta trabajamos en redondo y vamos a aumentar hasta tener 12 puntos bajos. So now I'm gonna start. Ahora voy a empezar con la vuelta número 2. I'm gonna start with round number 2. So there we go. and 12. Now we have 12 stitches around. Ahora bajos alrededor. Voy a instalar. I'm going so I have it in there. We are gonna move to round number 3. For round number 3, we have double single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next stitch around. And then the total amount of stitches that you will have at the end is 18. En español, tenemos la tercera vuelta. Y en la tercera vuelta tenemos un punto bajo y un aumento hasta tener 18 puntos bajos. Ok, are you ready? Let's go.
Make a second post with the images.
Yeah. Okay, so now we have 18. Ahora 18 puntos bajos. We are changing our stitch marker into the place that we finish. Cambiamos el marcador. And then drink some water. And say hi. How is looking? And I hope that you are joining us. And now we have number 3. Going very well. We had some hiccups in the beginning. Also, I hope that you are liking this and let us know if you can hear. Going fine. John is ahead and in English so that you can ask. Now, continue with round number 4. So for round number 4, wait, I have a little bit of hair in my eyes.
Okay, now the pictures are live.
Okay, now the pictures of the head, the pattern of the head is live. You can access it from the Facebook page and is in English and in Spanish. Como les estaba comentando en inglés, el patrón para la cabeza ya está subido a la página y está en español. Hay parte 1 y parte 2 para que nos sigan en caso de que no puedan estar en el live stream hoy, para que se desatrasen y nos sigan la próxima semana, que se viene el resto del patrón. So you can catch up, and then we can continue next week. So, now we continue with round number 4. And in round number 4, we have double single crochet in next stitch, and single crochet in next 2 stitches around, and the total is 24 stitches. En español es vuelta número 4, 2 puntos bajos, un aumento hasta tener 24 puntos bajos. Okay, so are you ready? Here we go. I'm gonna cut first this little tail in here because it can be confusing. And now we go with round number four. Two. Oops. 24. Ok, la ronda número 4 está lista. Cambiamos el stitch marker. Round number 4 is ready. We change the stitch marker to the place that we are, and we stretch a little bit our project, and then I drink a little bit of water. And we continue. I hope that you guys catch up pretty soon. The time zones are very different, but we thought that maybe this one will be a lot easier for many people because you come from work and things like that. So I hope that you can catch up pretty soon. If not, the video is gonna stay in the page and everything is fine. So hello to the silent ones that are watching us right now. And we are gonna continue with round number 5. So for round number 5 we have double single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next 3 stitches around, and the total is 30 stitches. En español es vuelta número 5, 3 puntos bajos, un aumento hasta tener 30 puntos bajos. Ok, are you ready? ¿Están listos? Let's go. Ten.
You have to keep your hands down.
Okay.
It's always sharp down there, so yeah. Oh.
And 30. 30. We change the stitch marker, cambiamos el marcador, y de ahí Seguimos al la vuelta número 6. Round number 6. I think I have to start writing down in where are we, because I can lose the counting while I'm here just talking. So we are in round number 5 now. Okay. Little bit of water. Again, say hi to the ones that are looking at us. Thumbs up if you like this video. And that maybe you are there crocheting in silence and you don't like to be disturbed. I'm also like that. When I'm counting, I lose my counting really fast. So I'm just like completely antisocial. But I'm gonna try my best to talk while we go into the long rounds, because it could be that there's prolonged minutes of silence for a while, but you know what, how it is, you know how it feels. So let's continue. Round number 6. For round number 6, we have double single crochet in next stitch, single crochet in next 4 stitches around, and the total is 36 stitches. And en español, vuelta número 6. 4 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 36 puntos bajos. I'm writing here that we are in round number 6. And are you ready? I'm ready. So, let's go. No problem, Alejandra. My pleasure. I'm happy that you are joining us now. Thank you. Hi. It's already starting getting shape. We are starting to get that sphere. Ya casi se forma una esfera. And 36. So now round number 6 is ready. You should have 36 stitches around. Ya la vuelta número 6 está lista. Deben tener 36 puntos bajos alrededor. Y voy a estirar un poquito porque me duele la mano. Y tomar agüita. I'm gonna stretch a little bit, drink some water, and then the next round is round number 7. For round number 7, we have double single crochet in each, no, double single crochet in next stitch, and single crochet in next 5 stitches. Now, en español is séptima vuelta, 5 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 42 puntos bajos. You should have 42 stitches at the end of this round, round number 7. Are you ready? Are you ready? I'm ready. Now here I need to start concentrating, because when the stitches become longer and longer, you can lose the counting faster and faster, easier and easier. Pretty soon we are done with round number 7. All right, now we are ready with round number 7. We change the stitch marker, cambiamos el marcador y estamos listos con la ronda número 7. Esperemos que enfoque. Let's wait until it focuses again and then we can continue. But again, I need to rest a little bit, say hi to the ones that are watching in silence. Which is your favorite candy for Halloween? Mine are, I don't know the name, but it's a candy that has a watermelon shape and it has some powder inside and it looks exactly like a watermelon, and it was my childhood favorite one and I love it. So let me know which one is your favorite candy. And now we continue with the pattern. We go to round number 8. For round number 8, you will do double single crochet in next stitch and then single crochet in next 6 stitches around, and the total is 48 stitches. And en español es, no, it's the other one. Yeah. En español es la vuelta número 8. Y en la vuelta número 8 tenemos 6 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 48 puntos bajos. Okay? Are you ready? I'm ready. Let's go. Maybe a little bit of water. Whew, when you talk a lot, you get very thirsty. I know that now there's 7 people that is joining us. Let me know which one is your favorite candy and what are you doing for Halloween. Okay, round number 8. This is a good thing to do when you are crocheting and talking at the same time. You write here in which round you are and what means that round. Why? Because sometimes we are in public transport, or you are with your partner here, or whatever, and then it's very easy to lose the count, or then you know more or less. You have a guide. Okay, let's start. Too much talking, very little crocheting. 1 and 2. Then we do 6. Almost there. Ya casicito, ya casicito. All right. Round number 8 is ready. We change our stitch marker. Cambiamos para el lugar donde terminamos. La ronda número 8 está lista. Thank you, Marty Evandik. I hope I pronounced your name well. Muchas gracias y un besito para ti también. Claro, hay que tener uñas de bruja. You have to have witch nails. If you are in Halloween, this is my favorite time of the year, so I go full witchy during this time of the year. Thank you for your comment and a big hug, abrazos para ti. Okay, so now we are in round number 8 and I drink a little bit of water. Say hi to you guys that are silent in there. I hope that you are crocheting with me this pattern. Let me know if you are doing it and how is it going. Maybe you can show me your projects and then we can see how is it going. I can share it in our Facebook page with your name. Now we are going to round number 9. For round number 9, we have double single crochet in next stitch and then single crochet in next 7 stitches around. For that you will have 54 stitches in the end, and en español es la ronda número 9. En la ronda número 9, vuelta número 9, tenemos 7 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 54 puntos bajos. Are you ready? ¿Están listos para la vuelta número 9? Okay. Then here, round number 9, we have 7 and 2. All right. Here we go. A la carga. And 7. Siete. I'm becoming more silent because I can lose the counting, but five, six, and 7. But remember, tell me which one is your favorite candy. What are your plans for this Halloween? Please, we are ready. Ya casi estamos listos. Acuérdense de comentarme cuáles son sus caramelos favoritos y qué van a hacer este Halloween. ¿Van a salir? ¿Van a festejar? ¿Se van a disfrazar? And we are done. Okay, so now we have this round. That was round number 9. And you should have, how many was that we need to have? In round number 9, you need to have 54 stitches. In your project. Ya estamos en la vuelta número 9. Tienen que tener 54. En la vuelta número 9 necesitan 54. Is everything okay?
It started looping the sound. Can you wait?
Yeah.
I don't think we can play it here.
Okay, but it's fine. Okay, sorry about that. We had a little bit of technical difficulties here, but now everything is fixed. And now we continue with the crocheting. A little bit of water. It's a bit warm here. And now we are going to round number 10. And in round number 10, we are almost in the middle. So I hope that pretty soon we can hit the needle and continue. So for round number 10, we have 1 single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next 8 stitches around, and the total will be 60 stitches. En español tenemos vuelta número 10. En la vuelta número 10 tenemos 8 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 60 puntos bajos. Okay, remember to change your stitch marker always to the place where you are. Acuérdense de cambiar el marcador. A mí a veces se me olvida, pero cuando me acuerdo, lo cambio. Sometimes I forget about it, but I try to always keep it up. Okay, so again, I'm gonna make my writing here. Round number 10, and then it's 8 and double single crochet. Then I know where I am.
You can tell that the pattern is also uploaded as pictures, in case people are wondering.
The pattern is also available in our Facebook page as a picture, and you can get it from there, so you can catch up later. El patrón también está en la página como una foto. Y de ahí lo pueden coger y se lo pueden llevar y desatrasarse para que nos sigan la próxima semana, the next Wednesday. We are gonna continue with the body. El miércoles que viene seguimos con el cuerpo. Okay, so we are in round number 10, and here we go. Thanks for the thumbs up and the likes that we just got, and the heart. We love you too. We are happy that you like this. Okay, I'm halfway around number 10. last group, and then we are finished with number 10. And we are done with number 10, round number 10. Estamos listos con la vuelta número 10. Estiramos un poquito el proyecto. Esto es como se ve, más o menos. This is how it looks now, so far. We changed the stitch marker to the place where we finish. And then cambiamos el marcador al lugar donde estamos. Y yo tomo agüita and I drink a little bit of water again. All right. I need to move a little bit my hands. It's very important to stretch. Because then that way you can crochet for many, many, many years. Otherwise, we get carpal tunnel syndrome, tendinitis, and all kinds of things. Okay, so now we are going to round number 11. And in round number 11, we have double single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next 9 stitches around. This is the last one of the augmentations, and then we start crocheting around. So in total, you should have 66 stitches. Y en español, vamos para la vuelta número 11. Y en la vuelta número 11 tenemos 9 puntos bajos y un aumento hasta tener 66 puntos bajos. Ok, so this one is gonna be long. So let me know your favorite candy, your plans for Halloween, or if you are making a party, what are your plans for Halloween? My plans for Halloween is graduating, which is amazing. I wish I could be dressed as a witch while I go receive my diploma, but I can't. Anyways, round number 11. So let's go.
Don't have any music, do you?
No. Pretty soon we are ready. in that round and I can talk again. I still don't domain that skill of talking and crocheting at the same time. Please. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 9, and then last round. Alright, so now we are ready with round number 11. Ya estamos listos con la vuelta número 11. We change the stitch marker to the place where we finish. Cambiamos el marcador. Y esto es como se ve. We stretch a little bit. This is how it looks so far. We have finished with all the augmentations. Terminamos con todos los aumentos. And now we are gonna go around and around for... from round number 12 to round number 20, but before that, I think that maybe we should have a break of 1 minute so I can stretch a little bit my hands and drink some water and answer here some of the comments that we have. So, in Mexico, there is a strawberry candy covered in bittersweet powder. That is my favorite. Yeah, I agree. Those candies that have this different tastes, that you is not only sweet or is not only very bitter, are also my favorite. I like them. Here in Finland they have quite exotic candies that I have not been able to domain yet. They have one that is called salmiakki and is black, completely black, and it has the taste is like sweet but mostly is salty, and it, I don't know, many people like it, but I have not been able to enjoy that taste. It's very Finnish, and they have also so another one that is dark as well. It's called licorice, and that one tastes very delicious. I really enjoyed that one, but if I could choose, I would choose the same one that you have in Mexico. They have strawberry candy and then some bitter sweet taste. Okay, so let's drink some water and then maybe I can ask John if he can pass me some of my candies that are over there. Now that we are talking so much about candies, they are in the chest in the other room. We are talking so much about candies that I got a little bit of cravings, but let's see. Thank you. This is one of my favorite candies of when I was a child. It's called Nerds. Here, I can show it. I saw it today in a computer store and I just had to buy it. It's so nice. I remember that I was saving all my allowance to buy this thing. I know that is a little bit... it says that it doesn't have artificial flavors, but I'm sure that it has. But I still love it, and I never got it as a trick or treat, but I will save my money and buy it. I still love it a lot. Alright. So now we continue. Como le estaba preguntando a las otras personas en inglés, ¿cuáles son sus planes para Halloween? Cuéntenme si se van a disfrazar, si van a hacer una fiesta, qué disfraz se van a poner, o si están haciendo algún otro proyecto en crochet. Comenten aquí abajito. Cuando termine la otra ronda, yo les contesto. ¿Ok? So... let's continue. So now we go to round number 12. From round number 12 to round 20, we are gonna just crochet around and around and around. So that one is gonna be a little bit long. So what I do, if I want to tuck and I want to crochet at the same time, I just place a paper here, and every time I do a round, I make a line. Then I know that I'm in round number 12, 13, or 14. So, are you ready? I'm ready. Le voy a comentar a las personas también en español. Cuando quiero hablar y quiero crochetear al mismo tiempo, lo que yo hago, si es crochetear alrededor, sin necesidad de hacer algún aumento ni nada, lo que yo hago es que empiezo a hacer palitos. Entonces ya sé, estoy en el en la vuelta número 12, en la vuelta número 13, vuelta número 14, y así no me vuelvo antisocial y puedo hablar con las personas al mismo tiempo. Ok, so, round number 12. Are you ready? I'm ready, let's go. As far as I know, here in Finland, Halloween is not a big tradition. They have the kids dress up as well, but not in Halloween. The kids dress up during Easter. They dress as witches, and it's a pagan tradition, and they go search for the eggs, and they eat lots of chocolate and candy, and they go from house to house, and then people give them candy. That is what we do in the rest of the world in Halloween. Kids dress up and then they get candy in the houses. When I was a child, I loved Halloween. I still love Halloween. And my mother will start working in our costumes very early in the year. Como les estaba comentando en inglés, en Finlandia, el día de los brujitos, Halloween, no es tan común. Los niños aquí se disfrazan es en Pascua. Y ese día los niños y las niñas se disfrazan de brujas, con ropa que tengan en las casas, y hacen unas escobas, y de ahí salen a buscar huevitos de Pascua, y la gente les regala caramelos en la calle. O ellos también van de casa en casa y les van regalando caramelos, y así es la misma tradición que en Halloween, pero se hace durante las Pascuas. Se les dice las brujas de Pascua. Y también les estaba contando en inglés que a mí me encanta Halloween, es una de mis fechas favoritas, y desde pequeñita siempre me había gustado disfrazarme, y mi mamá me hacía los disfraces y empezaba desde muy 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 temprano en el año a hacer los disfraces, pero a ella le encantaba porque aprendía a coser y aprendía a hacer decoraciones y todo eso. Entonces nosotras siempre íbamos al colegio llenas de maquillaje hasta el cogote, pero muy contentas. That my mother loved to make the Halloween things, and she will put lots of time into it, like almost half a year, and she will make lots of costumes for us. Every year she will make lots of costumes, and then she will put a lot of makeup in us. Thank you, Mitsue, for your comment. I send you a big, big hug. I know that it's very late. I'm gonna try to make one of the streams a little bit early. But since we are in the other side of the world, I have to try to put them somehow so everybody can have them. So yeah, I sent you a big, big hug, and I hope to see you soon, and I will try to make one for Japan. So I hope that you sleep well, and bye.
It's 3 a.m.
It's 3 a.m. What are you doing awake and so late? Are you crocheting or what? It's so warm. Okay, so now we are in round number 12. I finished round number 12, and this is how it looks so far. Then I make one line here, bloop, and I know that this is round number 12, and I can continue telling you stories about Halloween. Have you ever gone into a haunted house in Halloween? I have gone, not in Halloween, but I went to a haunted house a couple of times when the how do you call that place that when the amusement park was coming to town? It was called the Iron City, and they will have this spooky house that you will sit like in a train, and then they will scare you to hell. And I have always had a huge imagination, so only by going in that train and closing my eyes, and I will imagine all the monsters possible in the world, and I don't know why I didn't ever had a heart attack in there. And my sister was fascinated, I was just crying for my life in that train. So yeah, and many of my friends went to these really haunted houses where some people will chase them with fake, of course fake, but you think that is for real, fake chainsaws, and they said that it was amazing, and they invited me many times, but only by imagining the situation I was already freaked out, so I never went. ¿Alguna vez han ido a una casa embrujada? Yo una vez fui a una que vino a la ciudad, cuando vienen estos parques de diversiones itinerantes que les dicen la ciudad de hierro, y fui, y uno se monta como en un carrito, y eso lo mete a uno como entre unos huecos y unas cuevas, y yo me metí allá con mi hermana, y mi hermana era muerta de la risa, y yo era con los ojos cerrados, y como yo tengo una imaginación tan impresionante, yo solamente me imaginaba todas las cosas que estaban pasando, y ya, yo casi me da un infarto, pero sobreviví. Y ya cada vez que venía la mansión embrujada a la ciudad, como claro, uno tenía que ir porque había que acompañar a la hermana, yo me metía debajo del carro, del todo, y casi siempre las personas que eran los que asustaban en la ciudad, en esas casa embrujada, se daban cuenta que yo estaba muerta del miedo y me asustaban el triple. That when I was so scared and I was hiding under the car in that haunted house, the people that was inside the haunted house working, they would scare me triple because they knew that I was so scared, so they thought like, okay, here we have a perfect victim, and then they will just be there and they will touch me here in the back, and I would just try to hide more inside the car, which worked because I'm very small. I'm 150, so I could fit no problem inside that car. So yeah, I still enjoy being scared, but for some reason those haunted houses really freak me out. But I like horror movies if I have someone with me. Usually when the horrible part is coming, I just put my eyes like this, and I just look through this hole, and I feel like maybe this hole is protecting me from the monsters that are there in front. Que cuando yo veo una, a mí me gustan las películas de terror, me gustan, pero me da miedo, entonces me gusta ver películas de terror cuando hay una persona conmigo.
Outside of the picture.
But how can I be outside of the picture? There we are. Now I see myself here. And then I feel that when the horrible part of the story or the movie is coming, I put my hand in front and I leave a little hole so I can see through that hole, and I feel that maybe like that I get protected somehow. Let me know if you do the same. Probably, yes. Okay, so now we are finishing round number 13. We still have quite some to go. Change the stitch marker. Ya terminamos la vuelta número 13. Y cambiamos el marcador. Así es como se ve hasta ahora. Y ahora continuamos con la vuelta número 14. En esta vuelta voy a intentar hacerle un poquito más rápido para que nos rinda. I'm gonna try to be faster in this round. Now we are moving to round number 14, so we can be more effective. Could you open one window in the other room? Okay, so this one is going faster. Now the counting is becoming longer. And I can tell you, one anecdote of Halloween, that was that I had a friend and she will always get a very nice dress for Halloween. She had like Queen of the Swans, Princess of the whatever. She always was dressed as a princess or as a queen. And my mom, she liked to be like more challenging with those things. So she would dress me as like sun or Japanese or Hawaiian and things like that. But I wanted so hard to be the swan queen, but not because it was something about princesses or was something about queens. It was because it was so soft, that dress, and I was just touching her dress all the time, and she was so kind that one time she loaned it to me and my mom dressed me as the swan queen, and it was really nice. I still like to dress up, but here in Finland, Halloween is not a big celebration, so there's not so many costume parties and things like that. Is Halloween a big party in your town? What are you doing for Halloween this year? ¿Qué están haciendo ustedes para Halloween este año? ¿Es Halloween una celebración grande en sus ciudades o una celebración pequeña? Cuéntenme aquí en los comentarios mientras yo termino la vuelta número 14 y sigo directamente con la vuelta número 15. Let me know in the comment sections while I finish the round number 14 and I continue directly with round number 15, because I still have energy from the candy that I ate. Switch the stitch marker, cambiar el marcador siempre. Hay que cambiar el marcador. Ya vemos que se empieza a ver la esfera. Now we see that the sphere is starting to show. I have a little bit cone in here, but I can fix it here in the, and with the filling I can fix it. And now row number 15, I will write here 13, 14, 15. And now we continue, row number 15. The song that we, well, you sang in Halloween when you wanted to go to make that trick or treat was, in Spanish it said, I want candies for me, and if you don't give them to me, I'm gonna, how do you say, squeeze your nose. But then, since in Colombia we have had a history of violence, all the mayors in and the president suggested that we change the song. And the song that you had to sing was, I want peace, I want love, I want candies, if you can be very kind and give them to me. And we never took serious that song. I mean, the song about twisting the nose of the others, we thought that it was awesome and it sounded like a rhyme and it was short, and then they start telling us to sing that thing that was very, like, for us was lame. And now no one in Colombia sings the tricky tricky Halloween song that was the typical one. En la escuela, cuando yo estaba en la escuela, teníamos la canción típica para pedir dulces que se llamaba Tricky Tricky Halloween, y decía que le iban a pinchar la nariz, y si uno no le daban dulces, le iban a pinchar la nariz. Y el presidente, o yo no me acuerdo quién fue, el que hizo la sugerencia, que como en Colombia siempre había tanta violencia que no le podían enseñar a los niños a utilizar amenazas. Que cuando usted le decía a una persona, le voy a arrancar la nariz, era una amenaza e incitaba a la violencia. Y entonces nos pusieron a cantar una canción que decía, quiero paz, quiero amor, quiero dulces, por favor. Y todos creíamos que era muy, como muy aburrida, porque no decía nada como de Halloween, que alentara, no la maldad, pero lo que, como ese espíritu de Halloween. Y entonces nosotros solamente nos reíamos porque nos parecía como muy boba la canción. Pero la verdad es que esa canción fue la que ya se convirtió en la canción típica de Halloween, que dice, quiero paz, quiero amor, quiero dulces, por favor. And that's the typical song of Halloween for Colombia. I want peace, I want love, I want candies. If you are very kind, I give them to me. That's the song. What are your anecdotes of Halloween? Do you have any funny costume that your mother made to you? Or did you went to some party and something went awry? Or ¿qué anécdotas tienen ustedes de Halloween que me puedan contar? Que no sean muy, muy penosas para contar. I have one that is that. But first I'm gonna finish this. I'm finishing row number 15. I'm done with row number 15 now. This is how it looks now. Now we see that we are starting creating the sphere. Here's how it looks in the back part. And now we go to row number 16. We are still crocheting around. And now to the anecdotes. First, I take some water and I stretch a little bit. Oh. A big hello to the guys that have been watching us, that have sticked with us all these hours. I know that this is a little bit long, but as you see, we are making a witch, and this witch is a little bit more complex. It's not a pattern for beginners. It has lots of details. So today we are making the head. Here I'm gonna show it a little bit better. Here it is. This is how it looks. We are making the head, and then next week we are gonna make the body. And we are telling our stories of Halloween. We are telling which ones are our favorite candy. And if you are celebrating Halloween, and what are you doing for Halloween? Now we are going to round number 16. I'm gonna crochet two rounds pretty fast and tell you some more stories about Halloween. There was one time that I got lots of candies that I could give to other children when they knocked the door in our home. And what I did, since all the kids were showing like, oh, I got this amount of candy, and I got this amount of candy, was that I hid all the candies and I put them in my own bag, and then I didn't give any candies to anyone, and then I just came to school and I showed them that I had 3 bags full of candies, but all of them were of the same kind. And they were very suspicious, like, how did you got so many candies of the first, of the same kind? And I just tell them like, ah, it was a coincidence. And I had so many candies that I couldn't eat them because my stomach was hurting, and I was eating a lot of them. But I had candies like 6 months after, and my mother had to throw them away because I didn't want anyone to steal them. So I hid it with all my notebooks. And you can imagine that in Colombia, the temperatures are quite high, so it was a sticky mess. And that was the end of the candy. I think then after that, she was hiding the candies quite high, because again, I'm very short, so I can't reach the cupboards. Still, I can't reach the cupboards. So yeah, then she will give the candies to the kids and not to me to give them to the kids. La historia es que una vez mi mamá me entregó todos los caramelos para dárselos a los niños cuando tocaran la puerta. Y yo, en vez de darle los caramelos a los niños, me los guardé todos. Y después fui al colegio a chicanearle a todos que me habían dado, que todos esos caramelos me los había conseguido yendo de puerta en puerta. Y entonces los chicos me empezaban a preguntar, las chicas me empezaban a preguntar por qué todos eran de la misma marca. Y yo les dije que era una coincidencia, que yo no sabía, que seguramente toda la gente del barrio los había comprado en la tienda de la esquina, pero nunca se tragaron la mentira. Y yo tenía tantos caramelos, que comía todos los días caramelos, me dolía la panza, y después de 6 meses todavía tenía caramelos y los había escondido en mi cajón donde tenía los cuadernos del colegio. Y como en Colombia las temperaturas son tan altas, se derritieron y todos los caramelos se pegaron en los cuadernos, y ya ustedes se imaginarán cómo eran mis cuadernos, todos llenos de dulce y pegajosos. Ya después de ahí, mi mamá lo que hizo fue que ella misma le entregaba los caramelos a los niños y los escondía en la parte de arriba del escaparate de la cocina, donde yo no alcanzaba y nunca alcanzaré porque soy muy bajita. Bueno, vamos en la 16. We are in round number 16. We still have four more left to go around. So now we are gonna continue to round number 17, and that one is also stitch around. Vamos a continuar con la vuelta número 16, con la vuelta número 17, perdón, y en esa vuelta también vamos a hacer puntos bajos alrededor sin aumentar. Okay, this is how it looks so far. I'm gonna drink some water. And move a little bit the muscles and the neck. And then continue. I haven't still installed the safety eyes. I have them here with me. This we are gonna do when we are making the decreases, so keep them beside you, and we are gonna do it a little bit later. Okay, so continuing to round number 17, I'm gonna do two rounds fast. And I'm gonna ask John if he could give me some more water. Thank you. Thank you. What is John's favorite candy? No candy? Okay, no candy. Okay, so we are in round number 17. We have a few rounds left of stitch around, and then we are gonna start with the decreases, and then we are done for today. This is the biggest part of the pattern, so it will take some time. Every amigurumi designer has different techniques and different aesthetics. For me, I love to have the heads very, very big. So that's why they take a little bit longer time. Cada amigurumi, diseñador de amigurumis o de juguetes de amigurumi tiene su propia técnica y sus propias preferencias estéticas. Por eso es que mis amigurumis tienen una cabeza tan grande, porque en la cabeza es donde yo pongo casi todos los detalles. Ok, so now we are in round number 17. We are moving to round number 18. We are doing the same, stitch around. Vamos para la vuelta 18. Y en la vuelta 18 seguimos haciendo puntos bajos alrededor sin aumento. For example, there's some amigurumis that have very small head, big bodies. Some that have big heads, small bodies. What I have found with my research is that that's totally okay and that there's no really rules about that. Hay algunos amigurumis que tienen una cabeza grande, otros que tienen una cabeza pequeña. Lo que yo he encontrado en mi investigación sobre amigurumi es que no existe ninguna regla sobre el tamaño de las extremidades de un amigurumi. Okay, so this is round number 18. Este es la vuelta número 18. Ya casi estamos listos con las vueltas alrededor. ¿Cuál es su caramelo favorito? ¿Van a celebrar algo de Halloween? ¿De qué se van a disfrazar? Aquí ya alguien nos contó que su caramelo favorito era fresas con un polvito que las hace como ácidas. Someone here told me that their favorite candy was strawberry and that it has like a powder that makes them be, a little bit sour. And then someone also said that my accent is nice. Thank you guys, and thank you for the pattern, you're welcome. I hope you enjoy it. Y alguien también comentó que mi acento era graciosito y bonito. Y que muchas gracias por el patrón. Y yo les respondo que con mucho gusto, que mientras haya alguien que me siga, yo voy a hacer patrones. Okay, so now we are close to round number 18. We have two more to go and then we start decreasing. All right, so I'm gonna continue directly to round number 18, no, number 19. But first, I switch the stitch marker. Forgot one stitch here. Yep. Listo, vamos a la vuelta número 19. En la vuelta número 19 es lo mismo, vamos a seguir haciendo alrededor puntos bajos. And here we go. I'm gonna make round number 19 and round number 20 at the same time. Voy a hacer la vuelta número 19 y la vuelta número 20 al mismo tiempo. No al mismo tiempo, pero seguido, para que la terminemos rápido. Mientras tanto, si les gusta este tutorial, regálenme un like o me cuentan que puede mejorar, si me escuchan bien, si me escuchan nítido, si la imagen se ve bien. If you like this tutorial, thumbs up or let me know what can we improve. If you liked it, if you can hear me well, so that we can fix for the next weekend when we are making the body, para nosotros poder arreglarlo para la próxima semana. La próxima semana estaremos haciendo el cuerpo. Next week we are going to be making the body. And the apron. Y el delantal. We are in round number 19. Estamos en la ronda número 19. Okay, we have finished round number 19, and now we move to round number... No, actually, we finish with round number 20 now. Okay, so this is how it looks when we have finished all the stitch around part. We change our stitch marker. Este es como se ve cuando hemos terminado todos los puntos bajos alrededor sin ningún aumento. Y ahora lo que vamos a hacer es que vamos a empezar a disminuir. Now what we are going to do is that we are going to start decreasing. So for that, we are going to put our yarn close. Make sure that we have the stitch marker in place. And I need some water. Okay, and stretch a little bit. Okay, as I was telling you, this is the longest part of the pattern. Why? Because as you see here is the head, and the head is quite big. The rest of the pattern is quite simple, but then we have the head that is very big. So you need to be patient and maybe put some music or something so you can keep entertained. And yeah, como les estaba comentando, en inglés, la parte más delicada del patrón y la parte más grande del patrón es la cabeza. Por eso es que se toma tanto tiempo. El resto del patrón no es tan largo. Pero hay que ser pacientes, tomar agüita y poner música o alguna cosa. Ok, so now we are moving to the decreases. For the decreases we have... round number 21. I have a little mistake in there in the writing of the pattern, but in round number 21 we should be doing invisible decrease in next stitch and single crochet in next 9 stitches. I'm gonna post the errata when I'm done with this tutorial, but then is round number 21 is the one that we have in round number 22, and is invisible decrease in next stitch and single crochet in the next 9 stitches. So, are you ready? In español. Ok, en español también se me fue un error ahí en la escritura. Lo que vamos a hacer en la vuelta número 21 es 9 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 60 puntos bajos. Ok, so we are ready to start. So first we make an invisible decrease. Now you can take it away. And then 9 single crochet. Cinco, 5, 6. 7, 8, 10, 9, and then again invisible decrease and 9 stitches. almost ready with this one. Nine, and then last part. Then we change our stitch marker, cambiamos nuestro marcador. Water. And now this is how it looks so far. Esto es como se ve después de la disminución en la ronda número 21, la vuelta número 21. Y ahora vamos para la vuelta número 22. Un saludo para los que todavía nos están viendo. Estamos haciendo una brujita. A very big greetings to all the ones that are watching us. We are making a witch, the evil witch. And this pattern is going to be available after the stream. And we are going to continue next week. For today we are making the head. Hoy estamos haciendo la cabeza. Ok, so now for round number 22. We have invisible decrease in next stitch and single crochet in next 8 stitches, and the total is 54. I have added another round that is not going there. It's in round number 21, and that's why I'm telling you that the round number 22 is the one that is round number 23. So I'm gonna post the errata here in the Facebook page. It was just one mistake, but it makes a big difference. Of course it doesn't make a big difference in the result, but when you read the pattern. So I'm gonna post the new version after this is ready. Okay, so en español, vamos para la vuelta número 22. En la vuelta número 22 hacemos 8 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 54 puntos bajos. Ok, so here we go. As we see now, it's starting to become like a sphere, pointy sphere, and pretty soon we are gonna be done. And 8. Then again we decrease, we make an invisible decrease. If you don't know how to make an invisible decrease, this is how it goes. Si ustedes no saben cómo hacer una disminución invisible, así es como se hace. Cogen un punto, you put take one, the next stitch, you yarn over, and then you take the next one, yarn over again, and then you yarn over all three. Cogen las tres puntadas y ahí pasan un punto en las 3. Ok. 8. And 8, and then we're gonna decrease and 8 again. And now we make a decrease, our last decrease of this round, la última disminución de esta vuelta. Cambiamos el marcador, we change the stitch marker to the place where we are. Then we look how it looks. This is how it looks so far. Like a sphere. And then we continue with the next round. And then the next round, we are gonna be doing the same, but we are gonna decrease only 7 stitches, and that will be a total of 48 stitches. Ok, so, en español, vamos para la vuelta número 23. En la vuelta número 23 hacemos 7 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 48 puntos bajos. Ok, are we ready? We still have energy. And we go. But first I'm going to take some water. Send you high again. Ask you which one is your favorite candy, what are you doing for Halloween, and continuing. Seven. Okay, so pretty soon we are finished with this round. Casi, ya casi terminamos esta vuelta también. Y seguimos con la vuelta para disminuir 6. 6 and 7. Quiet around here because we need to concentrate now. I'm counting stitches. Change to the stitch marker to the place where we are, and we finish the round number 23. Now we are gonna move to round number 24. Terminamos la vuelta número 23, así es como se ve hasta ahora. Y seguimos con la vuelta número 24. En la vuelta, in the round number 24, we are gonna be decreasing, not 7, but 6. And the total amount of stitches that you are gonna have is 42. En español, en la vuelta número 24 vamos a disminuir 6, vamos a hacer 6 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 42 puntos bajos. Ok, are we ready? Are we still there? Having energy for finishing this head? We are almost done. Un, dos. Six. Then we decrease again. Hacemos otra vez una disminución. Y seis. And six. And we are almost done with this round too. No worries. Okay, and one last of this round. Okay, wow, it smells like smoke. I did it so fast, it started smelling a little bit. Not really. Okay, so now we finished this round. This is how it's looking so far. We are almost there. So now we continue with now we need to make invisible decrease in next stitch and then single crochet in next 5 stitches, and the total amount will be 36. That was the round number 25. Now in español, vuelta número 25. 5 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 36 puntos bajos. Pretty soon the hardest part of the whole pattern is done, and then we can move forward. Remember to change your stitch marker to the place where you finished. Then continue. Now I see that there's some more people joining us. We are making a witch. Estamos haciendo una brujita para Halloween en nuestro Crochet Along 2016. And I'm asking you guys which one are your favorite candy, if you have any plans for Halloween. And while we are crocheting here the witch, today we are making the head. Tres. And then next week we are going to continue with the body. Okay, we are almost done with this part. And then we can continue with the rest of the decreases that are shorter. And five, and then the last one. All right, so now we finish this round, and this is how it looks. Now we have to start like making it more round. This is how it looks. And now we have a few rounds to go. Only a few, so keep with us here. Tell us what is your favorite candy and what are you doing for Halloween and crochet at the same time with us. Vamos para la ronda número 26. En la ronda número 26 vamos a hacer 4 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 30 puntos bajos. In English, we are gonna go to round number 26. And then in round number 26, we have invisible decrease in next stitch and then single crochet in next 4 stitches. And that's will count 30 stitches. I added, as I said before, I added one stitch in the top. That is the round number 21 that is not supposed to be there and is messed up a little bit our counting. But I'm telling you now what it is and I'm gonna make the errata once the pattern is once this live stream is finished, so you can have the right pattern. So now we go to the round and start. We are almost done. Okay, so pretty soon we are reaching the end of this round again. Last group of these decreases. And then then we are finished with this part. Now we are gonna install our safety eyes and we are gonna attach a little bit of our stuffing. Thanks, Alejandra, for letting me know. I usually, I think it depends off every designer, but I tend to almost have the picture of the design and then I install the safety eyes, just because I like to put them in the center of the face and then I can have certainty that they are going where I want. So now we are gonna place them exactly in there. As you see here in the ready-made witch, we have them in the center of the face. And then I put them a little bit to the side so we can make an indent with the tapestry needle afterwards. So now I'm gonna attach them as well. And then for that, first I'm gonna also say it in Spanish. Alejandra me estaba comentando que ya la parte de la cabeza se está cerrando, que cuando poníamos los ojos, yo le comenté que yo casi siempre dejo que la cabeza esté casi hecha para tener la certeza de que los ojos van a estar puestos en el lugar exacto donde yo quiero que estén, y para eso entonces yo creo... Tejo casi toda la cabeza junta y ya al final le pongo los ojos. Ya solamente nos faltan dos rondas creo. Entonces ya tengo como certeza de dónde van los ojos y ahora los vamos a poner. So now we are gonna install the eyes. So for installing the eyes, what I do is that I know more or less where I want them to be. And then I just put the end part of mine hook, and then I try to like pull a little bit so I have space, and then it opens a little space in there, as you see. Lo que yo trato de hacer es usar la colita de mi aguja, la inserto en el lugar donde quiero poner mi ojo y lo abro un poquitito así para poder saber que ahí va a entrar el ojo bien, and then I put my eye and I make sure that it goes all the way, and then I take the next eye, I look that it goes in the same line that the other one is going, as you can see here. Let's see if I can go a little bit closer here, and then I insert the end of my hook also there, and I pull a little bit like this. Then you get a hole in your project, and then I insert my eye in there too. Hago lo mismo en el otro lado, miro que estén en la misma línea, ya de ahí miro si mis ojitos están en el lugar donde yo quiero que estén. Then I look if the eyes are in the place that I want them to be. I'm pretty sure about that. I like them. So then I just turn my project. Cuando esté segura, volteo mi proyecto un poquito. Parecen ojos también. And then I install the back part of the eyes, inserto la parte de atrás de los ojos. I make sure that it gets snapped really well, so then when you pull, you see that it's not coming off. me aseguro de que estén asegurados bien y que no estén saliendo. Ahí ya están los dos seguros. Now they are safe in there, and now I take my stuffing and I will add a little bit in the upper part of my amigurumi, so then it's easier to crochet the last stitches. So then I will just Add a little bit of stuffing in the upper part. The stuffing that I'm using is a recycled pillow. There you go. Now it's getting more full. I have more here. And then we add a little bit more. And now, at least, this is a very personal thing. So you have to experiment yourself. What is the easiest way that you can get these things? For me, it's a lot easier to crochet these last rounds when I have a little bit of stuffing inside. But you have to test yourself. Estaba comentando que para esto es muy personal. Para mí es más fácil terminar estas últimas rondas, vueltas, cuando tengo un poquito del relleno dentro. Pero es algo que ustedes, cada que hagan amigurumi, se van a dar cuenta que es lo más como cómodo para ustedes. Okay, so now we go to the round that we are decreasing, 3. So we are in round number 28. And in round number 28, that in the pattern that I'm gonna put in the errata will be round number 27, is invisible decrease in next stitch, and then single crochet in next 3 stitches. Ok, en español es, en la vuelta número 27 vamos a hacer 3 puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 24 puntos bajos. Ok, so let's go. We are almost done. As you see, I can graph easier the rest of the part that I have done already when I have a little bit of stuff in it. I can grab it with my hand. Con la mano puedo como apretar más fácil cuando tengo un poquito de relleno dentro del amigurumi. Me queda más fácil para poder tener tensión en la lana. It's easier for me to keep the tension when I can have a little bit of grabbing power in the... And then we continue. Oh, alright, so we are done with this round and now we only have one round left. So I'm gonna add a little bit more of the stuffing now. And you start like putting it in all the corners of your head so it becomes round and nice. And we start also shaping it a little bit Now we see that it's becoming rounder. And now we are gonna do the last round. In this round, we are gonna be decreasing. We are gonna be doing invisible decrease in next stitch and then single crochet in next two stitches, and the total amount of stitches that you should have is 18 stitches. En español, tenemos la vuelta número 28, que es dos puntos bajos y una disminución hasta tener 18 puntos bajos. Okay, so let's finish that one. And then we can move to the last part. After this head, on Wednesday next week, we are gonna be doing the body. The body doesn't take as long because it's smaller than the head. This is the longest part of the whole body, of the whole witch. And I want to make clear that I'm gonna be posting the errata of this pattern after the live stream is done, so you have the correct pattern. All right, so then after that, you change your stitch marker to the place where you finish. Then you add a little bit more of the stuffing, and I'm gonna explain you why I don't decrease all the way to the end. Once I finish stuffing here, agregamos un poquito más de relleno. Y ya les voy a explicar por qué yo no termino todas las puntadas hasta cerrar el proyecto. You need to make sure that your sphere is filled completely, so then it doesn't look fluffy and weird. This might take a while, but tienen que asegurarse de que tienen suficiente relleno dentro de la esfera para que no se vea raro, para que la esfera no se vea desproporcionada y para que no haya partes como con hoyitos y así. Okay, so I think after this one I have enough. This is how it looks so far. Then I will try to like mold it, place the stuffing in all the corners here. For example, I'm missing, you can feel right away. So I take a little bit and then I add it in that part. Now I'm getting satisfied with what I can feel here, a little bit more here. And then yo Yes. And then, wait, I need to do it in here. I can do it in here if I can move the, here, select the start time tomorrow. Okay, yeah, now we are back. So I'm making it round and nice, and now we have our head. The last part of this pattern is that we will need to make, as we see here with the witch, if I put it on the side, you can see that the eyes are going to the inside. And this is totally optional because I like that the amigurumis that I designed look a little bit like us. And we don't have the eyes to the outside. We have a little bit of an indent in our eyes, this part in here. Les estaba comentando que ahora vamos a hacer una hendidura en los ojos. Y esta parte es totalmente personal y opcional. La hendidura en los ojos es porque a mí, como diseñadora, no me gustan los amigurumis que tienen los ojos hacia afuera. Y hace muchos años que los hice así, pero ahora me he dado cuenta que los amigurumis que a mí me gusta hacer, me gusta que se parezcan a las personas y que tengan una, como los ojos un poquito hundidos hacia adentro, como se puede apreciar aquí cuando lo pongo hacia afuera. Esta parte es opcional. Ok, so for that I'm gonna cut now and leave a long tail of the head and then just pull the string. Why I'm not decreasing all the way to the end? Because for making this amigurumi, when you see here in this part, it is a lot easier to sew it if we don't decrease all the way to the end. You can have a more neater sewing than when you finish all the way to the end. Para hacer este amigurumi no necesitamos terminar la esfera hasta el final porque es más fácil y queda más bonito coser el amigurumi en unir las partes cuando todavía hay un pedazo que falta. Se ve más bonito y no hay que coser tanto, sino que se pueden coger las dos partes y solamente unirse más fácil. Por eso es. Okay, if you are interested in making the eyes, you will need your tapestry needle and then you will need the same color that we have been using. You cut a little string and then you just put it in the needle. Para hacer los ojos, la hendidura en los ojos, si quieren hacer la hendidura en los ojos, lo único que tienen que hacer es enhebrar la aguja capotera y we are gonna place it in this part, in the inside of the eye. De ahí pasamos la aguja capotera una vez en la parte de adentro del ojo, like this, and then we are gonna pass this, cut this little ending here, and then we need to pass it many times. So, to make the indent in the eye, para hacer la hendidura en el ojo, lo único que tiene que hacer es presionar los dos ojos hacia el centro con un poquito de fuerza, to press a little bit with your strength the eyes to the inside, and then you just need to sew. This part is a little bit tricky, but you sew this several times y pasar la aguja varias veces por la misma parte. mantener un poquito de fuerza y ya ustedes miran qué tanto quieren sus ojos que estén hundidos. And then you can check how much you want your eyes to be to the inside. You can have them very, 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 very to the inside to make a nose, or you can have them like me, that is just a little bit. And then you just keep going several times. When you are satisfied with the result that you have, then you just put your needle away and sew to the outside. Cuando ya están satisfechos con la hendidura que tienen, terminan pasando la aguja hacia la parte de afuera y cortan. Y ya estamos listos. And then we are ready. This is how it looks the head once you have finished all the way to the end. You need to mold it a little bit so the stuffing goes in the places that you want. Necesitan moldearla un poquito para que el relleno se vaya a los lugares donde ustedes quieren. Y ya terminamos. It was a little bit long this video, but as I told you, this is the longest and the biggest part of the whole pattern. This is how it looks, both of them. I have to turn them. So yeah, this is pretty much it. This is all what we have for today. If you are joining this crochet along, please let me know how is it going. If you have any questions, just don't hesitate in sending me a private message or making a comment in this live stream. This video will remain in this in our Facebook page. So don't worry if you manage to join us this time. Okay, catch up and join us later. Any suggestions or comments about this live stream? We are quite new with this. And now we have some music all of the sudden. No. Okay, so now we are back. Sorry guys. So yeah, so this is how it looks. Let me know if you made it. Let me know if you are joining this crochet along. Thank you very, very much for all your kind comments, for letting me know that you also want to see this in Japan. I'm gonna try my best to like split the times, not in this one but in the next one. Next Wednesday we are gonna be making the body. For that you need burgundy color and the same materials that we were using today. I hope that you guys like this. Let me know what you think and see you soon. A big hug and see you next Wednesday. Bye.